that took a lot of second there, guys. Sorry about that. YouTube wasn't getting the data from Restream. The horror of it all. But we're here, we're live, and we're about to start our opening song, so I hope you're ready for that. When I hit the go live button chat, and studio light hurts my eyes, ad breaks without warning me, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at chat, and I grab my headset tight. Just one look at chat, and I know it's gonna be, alright, everyone sing with me, a lovely, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream. When the Lego set ahead of me, first we gotta fly the plane. Taking off's the easy part. Throttle up, pull the yoke back. Then I look at chat, and I turn on autopilot. Just one look at chat, and I know it's going to be. All right, everyone, sing along with you. In other words, a lovely, lovely stream, 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 a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream. When we get to cruising altitude, we'll build that Lego set. We'll redeem some Mahal Awards points. Always the very best time. Then I look at chat, and I spin the wheel. Just one look at chat, and I know it's going to be. All right, everyone, this is a long one. Let's go for it. A lovely, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream. I had a peanut and it in my throat right now. Lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream. Sorry, I didn't want to get some drink in me. Purple drink. Lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, 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 a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, a lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream, lovely stream. Yes, it's been a lovely start to the stream so far. I'm having a good time. I hope you're having a good time too. We're gonna switch on over to the just chatting screen so we can get this bad boy going. There I am. Aloha, welcome to the stream. You can call me Craw. I'm a father who flies virtual planes while building Lego sets. I apologize that I'm wearing my basic dad outfit today of a Adidas tracksuit. It's the first Sunday of the month. It's always a little more hectic in my world when it's the first Sunday of the month. Our church has an event for kids at night on the first Sunday of the month that goes from 5 to 6:30, and yeah, this is all I got. I'm lucky I got to stream relatively on time. I know I started about 5 minutes late, but that's because I was not paying attention to the clock. I was literally ready at 6:57, but then I was like, I got 3 minutes. Let's just mess around and do stuff while we don't go live, because we do not need to be live at this exact moment. So what are we going to go live early for? Right? Like, sad reality. Sad, sad reality of all that stuff. Aloha, Cloveros. I just was apologizing for wearing a tracksuit, so mahalo for the compliments, my friend. I was telling everyone that the reason why I'm unfortunately wearing a tracksuit as opposed to my normal stream attire is because the first Sunday of the month is always a little more hectic for me between church commitments and all those other things, so I barely made it on time to stream. Like, I got everything set up at 6:57, and I'm sure there's something I missed. But how are you doing? Anyone in chat, if you don't already know the wonderful Clover Rose, please check her out. She's phenomenal. Clover Rose, also, I want to just verify that you use the she pronouns, because you never know. She's a virtual streamer. She uses VTuber stuff, you know, and it's phenomenal artistry, and I always greatly appreciate herself. Clover Rose is a chill VTuber who's been hopping the kingdom from kingdom to kingdom. They tackled divine beasts in Zelda with the grace of a gazelle on ice skates. Then they soared with Rito's, probably asking, why did the Loftwing cross the sky to get Van Vamoda, duh? And let's not forget the shell-shocking victory over Bowser. Must have been a Koopa Troopa triumph. Tune in for the puns and doing, folks. This is stuff. Yes, okay, cool. She did verify that she uses she, her. Phenomenal, just super wonderful. Just one of those voices that you could, like, listen to, read the phone book, if that's what her stream got to at that point. My stream hopefully will never get to that point. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but, you know, I know that if I ever did that, I would get zero views, because I've got a wonderful voice. I have the face for radio. If you've never heard that expression, there's an expression that I've got a face for radio, which means basically, like, if you're a radio personality versus a television personality, it's because you're just not good looking enough. So that's what it is. That's the joke there. So I'm saying I have the face I have the voice for television, because my voice is not good enough to be on radio. But I am an attractive human being, so I could have pulled off television if I wanted to. Anyways, enough talking about how wonderful I am as a person. How's your weekend? Are you having a good weekend? Are you enjoying yourself? Are you having fun? Did you things that made you say, I'm glad I had a weekend and not just 2 days off? That's why you're a VTuber. Well, you know, it'd be hard to do VTubing with the Lego brick building. I don't know how I could pull that off. Just saying. We'll figure that out at some point. Yeah. Someday we'll figure that out. Anyway, so we've posted all the stuff that we published, and now what we can do is we can get going with our flight. That's what we can do. I meant to do this one thing before, and that's what I got kind of stuck on, because I was, like, doing some stuff and I wasn't thinking about where I needed to go. Need to put the flight information over here so I can enter it. The thing that was distracting me so much today was I realized that this is currently, believe it or not, my 489th stream here on Twitch. 489 times I've gone live. It means I'm 11 streams away from 500. And right now I'm in the process of coming up with what would be a good 500 stream celebration. I've got a couple ideas floating around in my head. And I'm pretty excited about that, like, what we want to do. I've never been one really for milestones in terms of, like, I have 500 followers, but I think 500 streams is something worth celebrating. Heck, 10 streams is worth celebrating in my mind, but 500 really speaks the volumes of all the things I've been doing here on Twitch, all the way since my first stream on January 30th of 2020. So 4 years. I've been just doing this for a little over 4 years, so it works out to being about 100 and something. Aloha, lady. Welcome into the stream. So right now we're putting together some stuff that we're thinking through and putting it together. But right now, and I'm just going to let you know that Sam said this was the cringiest idea he's ever heard me come up with for what we could do for a 500th stream. So as I always talk to people, it's like, it's very few people come on to Twitch and they start with something And then they keep doing it. Like, I'm sure there are people out there who started as a Fortnite streamer and 500 streams later, they're still a Fortnite streamer. And I think every streamer who's been on Twitch for 4 years or so, you evolve and you grow as a human being. You change what are the things that you do because you have varied interests and you want to try new things, and you grow and you develop as a person. So I sat down and I said, how can I honor all the different periods of my life, all the things that I've grown through? When I think about like how I started, what were the types of things that I streamed? What are the things over the years that I've streamed? Because I've been in a lot of different realms. For better or worse, I truly am a variety streamer. And when you look at my entire career, but there's never been a point where I feel like I was a variety streamer, you know? When I started off, I just played whatever game I wanted to play that day. And I did that for, you know, a couple of months. And then I got into playing Just Dance on stream. And then from Just Dance, I started doing fitness and then yada, yada, yada. And we've gone over this time and there's different categories that I've been in for periods of time and growth. And so, you know, I said to myself, I was like, I think there's an opportunity for me to take a page from Taylor Swift and do an Eras stream. And just kind of go through the different eras in my career on Twitch, right? Celebrate all the different things I've done, all the different ways I did. So I went through and I because I'm a data nerd, I have information on literally every stream I've ever done since my first one. And I pulled the data out to tell me what are the things that I've done multiple streams of. Craw era stream, yeah. And I've gotten it down to just a couple of things, right? And so I'm going to try to honor every single thing that I've done at least two streams of, right? So, like, if I did, like, there was this one game I played called A Short Hike. I played it once. I never did it again. I don't want to honor A Short Hike because at that point, I would have had to cram in 132 different eras. Yes, over 500 streams, I've played 132 separate games. So I boiled it down to, about 10 eras. And I'm going to, you know, just try to honor every single one of them to do something in this 3-4 hour stream that is going to look at my career and have different flashbacks. And we're working it out, but that'll be at the end of March, because that's when, if everything stays consistent with my current stream schedule, I should hit my 500th stream on March 30th. So as we get closer to it, you know, like when I'm at like 495, maybe I'll start promoting this. I just feel like right now we're 11 streams out and a lot can happen. But I think when I'm 5 streams out, it'd be very hard for me to not make a specific date. Because I'd hate to be like, it's my 500th stream and it's really my 498th. Like, that'd be silly to do that. But we're going to do that. That's the idea. That's the plan. And it's really going to be fun to kind of look back and see what some of my old streams look like. What they look like today. How did I grow? And play some of the games that I played, or play games I haven't played that are indicative of the games I've played. I'm just really looking forward to it. So I'm very glad that Lady got to be here for my Eras stream announcement. Because I feel like if anyone should be here for me to say that I'm going to do an era stream, it should be the one and only Lady Amalthea. And like I said, if you haven't already met her, please go check her out. She's a wonderful human being. She's one of my favorite people to watch. I almost catch every single one of her streams, but no one can catch every single one of the streams. But she does wonderful things, like she does. And I know it sounds like I'm having a mental break because I don't know what she does, but I do very much know what she does. She will do mental health streams in the mornings, and she'll do art streams, and she will also play games like Fortnite. And I'm sure if Lady sat down and said, I have to come up with 5 of the eras that I've been a part of, she would probably have just as eclectic thing as I have. So please check her out. She's a wonderful human being, and you can't go wrong if you follow her. I think you've got a crew of like 10 to 15 people who are very reoccurring, and I'm one of them. I would agree with that statement. Audrey wants to show off her nails, by the way. So, Audrey, what I'm going to do for you, we're going to go to this view so that we can get a good zoom in of them. Okay. Let's put them here on the table. Put them on the table. And then we're gonna.
You can't really see them.
Hold, Audrey. This is the great thing about this camera. I can.
You can zoom in it.
Yeah, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna zoom all the way in.
They're little chickens. Wait, I'm gonna turn my hands around.
They can get that they're chickens. No, put them down. Put them down. I will move the camera to you.
Okay. Well, my hands are this way.
Yeah. Turn around though.
What do you mean turn around?
Here. Right. There. Perfect.
Chicken.
Perfect. Those are phenomenal. I'm very proud of your chickens. Thank you for sharing them with my stream. Everyone is greatly appreciates them.
Bye.
She just really wanted to show you guys the chickens. She spent the weekend over at her aunt's. And that's what they did. And you got to give me 1 second because I have to get a towel because in the process of doing that, I knocked my drink over. There we go. Oh, I hope this isn't stained. This little tabletop that I have has been nice, but like I know I want to replace it, and I hope I just didn't stain the hell out of it. We'll see. We'll find out. Anyway, let's get flying because that's what we're here to do, right? That's what people want to see me do is fly planes. So let's get our world map going. Get our mouse all the way over there. So we got a great flight for you guys today. We're gonna be starting in a little town in South Africa called Joburg or Johannesburg. And we're gonna be starting at the airport FAOR. As you can see, it's a wonderful little airport with two runways. And then we're gonna be flying. Oh, yes. Prize wheel. I got to do the prize wheel. I should have had Audrey do the prize wheel when she was right here, but mahalo for reminding me of that. FVH. Why? Hippo Valley Airport. All right, let's get the prize wheel. And we're going to be starting on number 16. May the odds be in your favor, Lone Wolf. Six. Let's see what we have, number six.
Congratulations. Daddy has to be Lego with. Chopsticks. I don't know how to use chopsticks. Don't expect me to do this. Oh, yeah, I did it.
Yay! All right. As soon as we start building, we'll spend our first 5 minutes building with chopsticks. Just for you, Lone Wolf. Mahalo for that. We greatly appreciate you as a human being and everything you bring to my channel. Yeah, I don't think I've ever had to do chopsticks on stream. I don't think I've had that one yet. So it's the first time for everything. Let's see. Let's get to let's get our flight set up. There's our flight conditions. And cruise. Nope. That was wrong. Where's my cursor? There's my cursor. Nope. I swear. There we go. And then we can enter. Much lower. There we have that. Eventually, I'm going to learn how to use all the fancy gadgetry that I have and actually, like, do that over there. I'm working on it. I don't want to, like, do it on stream and spend, like, 5 hours doing it. I want to get, like, really good at it. And then we can do that. That's our flight conditions. We're going to try something new with today's flight, by the way. I'm pretty excited about it. So let's go fly. We're going to try something. I watched a good friend of mine who's way better at this piloting thing than I am, what he did was he flew over the airport, saw which direction was the runway, and then circled back and landed. And I was like, it's not a bad idea. I have to remember to do that myself. There we go, and we can slide that over here. It's still loading up. But in the meantime, we can come over to here, that, and then we can go... There it is. That's where I'm sitting. And I just realized I don't have my back pillow yet. All right, we have that. All right.
Tower Beechcraft 6801 ready for departure.
We're ready for departure. That is awesome. All right, we have all those on. We have that on. We can hit to turn off the parking brake. Or is it? One of these is for the parking brake to go off. Control number delete. I hit that. There it goes. Where are we flying to? Aloha, Starden. How are you doing? We're flying to Hippo Valley. Did you not vote on Instagram? That's where we're flying, Hippo Valley. I really should put something on screen that says where we're from and going to. Because I do feel like I get that occasionally. All right, and then we can lift off. Let's go, and up we go. This is a very big airport for us. Gear up. Let's clear the flight pattern before we turn around and go. And starting, I've apologized to everyone else, but I'm apologizing to you as well, that I am in my basic dad outfit. Hey, there you go. All right, we got our flaps up. And now we can start turning. I've already put up landing gear. There we go. We're turning very nicely here. Well, there's no shame in that. No shame in streaming your PJs. You know what it was? I've got a lot of people who I know and respect as streamers who put so much effort into their appearance. And I'm not saying if you don't, I don't respect you. I'm saying that there are so many people I know who put so much work into their effort. And those people are all women. I don't know any men who put any thought into their appearance and what they wear on stream and all those things, in terms of making sure their makeup looks good. And so that's one of the reasons why I strive to make sure that I'm wearing nice clothes when I'm on stream, because again, I want to show respect to all the women out there who are working very hard to put on good appearance, knowing that they're going to be judged for their appearance, Whereas very few people are going to judge me for my appearance, which is fine because I am really good looking. But, you know, yeah, that's just a sad reality of it all. That's just a sad reality of streaming. Oh, nope. Overcompensated. Flight assistant. Now that we're facing the right direction, we can turn on piloting. And here we are. We're now going to be flying on our happy way to Hippo Valley Airport. It's at this moment that I realize I don't have my Lego set with me. That is awesome. I'm glad that you guys enjoyed that. That was a great stream to be a part of. I had a lot of fun with that. Minimize Twitch Lego sets. Loop coaster. We're going to be starting with bag number 3. And yes, Lone Wolf, I know I need to use chopsticks, but I figure you would let me open the bag with my hands. All right, we'll put those over there. And these small ones we're going to throw in there. But also, Stardon, I want to pass to you the good news, because I don't know if you're here earlier. But this is my 489th stream on Twitch, which means I have a 500... I'm really concerned I'm not flying the path. No, I am. Okay. Crisis averted. But I have my 500th stream coming up, and I wanted to do a celebration of the 500th stream. So there's the easy way to figure out how many you've done that. You can go into your Twitch data as a creator. Go to monetization. I think analytics overview. So if you go to your analytics tab, you'll see a chart that says average viewers, follows, subscriptions, revenue, and time stream, and it will give you a period of like 30 days. If you click into that, you can pick custom dates. So it will give you options to pick. And what you could just do is go to when you know you started streaming, which is me, January 2020, and then pick to date, and then you can update, and then you can export the data. And once you've exported the data, you have a spreadsheet. Unfortunately, in that, it doesn't show your categories. It won't say, hey, this is your category that you did this in, and so I started exporting that data around stream 300 or so. And then once I had started exporting it, of course, I've just kept updating the data with what I need. And I went through like all the old VODs I had up on YouTube and all the places and just tried to catalog the best I could. I think I know what I streamed at 410 out of the 489 streams. Like, there were 70 streams I couldn't figure out what I did. So yeah, it's a spreadsheet. It's a spreadsheet, but that's how you would get the data for yourself. If you want to go down that road, that you want to know that information yourself. All right. What have we done on the build? Because I know that that is super important to all of you guys. So if you guys haven't been a part of this build already, this is your first stream where you're doing this. You're literally exporting this CSV. I'm proud of you. It mostly will give you stream information, like how many viewers you had, how many followers you have, stuff like that. Like, again, I spent a couple hours going through and filling in the data that I wanted, that I cared about, which is mostly categories. So this is the set that we're building. This is the Lego Loop Coaster set. It doesn't come on a sheet like this. If you look at this dark green area, this is what it looks like. I built this on Mills plate so that I could just easily pick it up and move it around and it wouldn't easily collapse. I didn't have this color, enough of this color green, so I have this other green that I'm just using temporarily. The goal is to replace all of this green with this green so that it matches. But yeah, I'm very happy to make my decision with this, because again, I can pick it up, I can take it off my desk, I can go put it over there. And when I build my city, I'll be able to take it in and slide it into my city super easily. It is beautiful. I love it. But things that we've done that we know we're going to have to account for when we actually sit around to finish the build. In the original build, this part had a little fence here that stood up. Let me zoom in. Right here. This had like a little slope, which of course I'm not going to be able to recreate the slope. I may end up taking these out because I just don't need them, and just continuing this path off this way. But there was some little things here that I'm going to have to account for to show kind of entrances to the ride. These may come up and be replaced with something like this that just continues onward. I just don't know what I'm going to do yet. The other thing, which I know is going to be a problem later on, is over here in this space here. It's about these six. So these six sets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the original build, this was a hole. And I didn't like it being a hole. I wanted to fill it with something. But right about here, they're going to have a piece like this go down below where this plate is. So when we get to that point, we're going to have to take off this so we can build down, and then I'll figure out what I need to do to fill the space that's been vacated by that. All right, so that's what we're doing. That's where we're going with our progress. Let's zoom out. Let's get a 5-minute timer on the clock so that we can do building with chopsticks for our lovely, lovely moderator, Lone Wolf, because he deserves it. There we go. Let's get to the page that we're on, because we're going to be starting with bag number 3. We skipped bag number 1, because bag number 1 is just kind of like accessory stuff, and it's not necessary for the build. This was bag 2, and this was bag 4. So we're going to go back and do bag 3. Or maybe this was one and this was four and this is three here. Oh, okay. I was went past what I needed to do. All right. Building with chopsticks is beginning. See, I'm going to start off. I'm going to need some of these pieces. Nope. No. Nope. This. I think I need one of the this piece. It's hard to tell if I need one or two of these pieces because this is a curved piece, but it's not flat, right? Like there's a little bit of a drop. Whereas this is a flat curve and it says I need two, but it looks like I need two of these ones. And not, and one of these, but I could be wrong. So we're gonna put those over here. And then this one piece. It was a top-notch spin. They really did a wonderful job spinning. We're very proud of their spinning choices in life. All right. No. So I'm going to give you a little trick that I know. I'm actually really good at using chopsticks. I was a foreign exchange student in Fukuoka, Japan. And so I'm actually really good for a white, especially for a white guy, at using chopsticks. So I need that. I'm going to need you. Now this is going to be fun because I need a six. So I need to get a six red. This is actually a very hard piece to pick up. Oh, probably easier to do it that way. We lost it. We'll get it when we don't need to use chopsticks. There. Perfect. I can measure it this way. And that is six. All right, and now what I need to do is I need to pick up that piece. And push it down like that. Y'all thought I was going to be bad at this. This next part might not be as easy as I think it is. It's going to require me to hold it like that and then line it up. Yeah, this is going to suck. And I'm not even have that in frame. How about this? We move this over here. We'll take this here so you guys can see it. And I have to do this three times. But we're only going to do one. In fact, what I want to do actually to make my life that much easier is we're going to get this and we're going to attach that down. Right? Like, now that I've attached it down, it's going to be much easier to pick things up and move things up. Aw, it started, and your sim had a science baby? Aw, that's exciting. Now, this is like The Sims, right? This isn't like a class assignment, right? Right? And I know I'm about to hit that 5 minutes, but I want to keep doing this because I want to, like, finish this one build. All right. Okay, that's tough because that wants to turn. There. My hand is cramping up on me. I want to build this pillar. Oh. Actually, I do not want to do that. We'll put that over there. We'll get another one. Because it's going to have the blue pieces on top. Right? Right? Like, that is going to be so much easier to line up. Look at that. Look at that. Admit it, you guys are impressed. Alright, and then the next one needs to go on. Alright, that was the timer, but again, like I said, I want to, like, build this whole pier that way. Right? Because once you get in that ledge, you can then take it and push it down. There we go. Okay, what's next? I need a third one. There we go. Right, and then I need another one to use. And actually, this is gonna be tricky. Because, like, with this one, I was able to put the brick on, and that helped me do it. This one, I have a plate. Right? Now that I have that plate, I will be able to have something that I can grip a little bit better. There we go. And that's it. Voila. I built this with chopsticks. Mahalo for that. That was phenomenal. That felt really good to do that. Now I can do it 3 times. It was so much easier it's going to be. Mahalo for the compliment, 12 Rose. Okay. You do know how much I love Battlestar Galactica, right, Lone Wolf? Like, you're not just teasing me, right? But Another Life. I've heard of it. I don't think I've watched it yet. How would you compare it to Battlestar Galactica? Because I do love me some Katie Sackhoff. I think she was one of the unappreciated gems of the Battlestar Galactica reboot. I cannot speak highly enough of her role or that show as a whole. I would say that and Lost are two of my absolute favorite shows of all time. I mean, I do love The Simpsons. I do love King of the Hill. But, like, those two, those are, like, God-tier television shows in my mind. And I know it's an unpopular opinion. That was buzzing that whole time. I know a lot of people do not like Lost. And I get why some people don't like Lost. Because they don't understand. They misunderstood what happened in the show. Because the number of times I've talked to someone and they're like, oh, Lost is so stupid. I hated it. And I've actually talked to them and I found out why they hated it. They've all been wrong. Right? I'm not saying that they're wrong for hating it. It's like the things that they thought the show did and didn't do was wrong. And it's a fundamental misunderstanding of the show that causes them to not like it. And it's such a big misunderstanding. It'd be like someone saying, I don't like Star Wars. Why don't you like Star Wars? Well, I just don't like pirates. You just don't like pirates? Yeah, I just don't like pirates and romance comedies. That's why I don't like Star Wars. Like, and that's the thing with Lost. People who generally do not like Lost, they generally talk about not liking it for the exact same reasons. And they're frankly wrong. I can now check that off. I've done that for Lone Wolf. We're building another one, and this one's a big boy. This is an unintended consequence of using this particular building system. Is like this just latched in super well. Like that. Like these are just held in place so well together. In fact, I like this so much. Not big enough. I want to build some undercarriage here so it doesn't tip as much. Okay, there you go. I like that. That's awesome. I will add it to the list of shows that I need to check out. And you say it's on Netflix, is that correct? Netflix is one of the few streamers that I have left. 12. Because we're like a lot of people, we're starting to purge streaming sites. Right, like we're not paying for Disney Plus anymore. Holiest of Toledo's, it's House of Jacobs Gaming, y'all. Y'all, this is one of my most OG fool people I know here on Twitch. I would say there's top five oldest friends of who I have known and paid attention to on Twitch. House of Jacobs, please check him out. One of the OGs. Wolfie, can you give him a shout out? Because, again, just a dude who's been around ages. And Jason, I want to tell you some big, exciting news. You probably passed this milestone years ago because you stream a lot more than I do. But this is stream 489 for me, which means I'm coming up on my 500th stream, and I'm going to be doing a 500 stream celebration. And I thought, what's the best way to honor? Because you're like me. You started doing some type of streams, and then you've grown and have evolved as a streamer, and you've tried different things. And some things you've stuck with and some things you haven't. And so I was thinking, how can I really pay homage to all the different periods of the, my growth, all the categories I've been a part of? So I'm doing an Eras stream in which we're going to play games from all the different eras of my streaming career. And I don't think anyone's ever done an Eras thing like that. Like, I don't think anyone's done like a Eras stream or an Eras tour or anything. Like, this is a completely original thing that I've done that no one else has done. Like, no other performer has ever tried to do something like that, ever. So yeah, we're gonna dust off some Just Dance stuff. We're gonna do a lot of fun, cool stuff that people who followed me for a long time, who've been part of the community for a long time, they will hopefully really appreciate and get a kick out of. And some of our newer friends, and not that there's anything wrong with being a newer friend, but maybe our newer friends will be like, okay, this is some of the stuff that Scraw's done. There we go. All right, now we need to build another one of these. But yes, an Eras stream. Crawl over the 4 years. Yeah, I mean, Jason's like me. I mean, we both start. Jason was doing Just Dance streams for a long time. He's done a lot of Lego building. He's done a lot of Pokemon. He's done so many things. He's grown and evolved, you know. And then, again, there's nothing wrong with someone if they join Twitch and they pump out 500 Fortnite streams in a row. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. You do what you got to do that passions you. But I think for a lot of people, they want to grow. They want to change. I'm excited about it. Me and the kids are working on it right now in terms of what do we want to do, how do we want to do it, how can I involve them, because they have been such an important part of my streaming life. In my life in general. So we're working out some stuff because, you know, like some eras, and maybe I should copyright that, like Eras stream, maybe a tour, I don't know, we'll figure it out. I feel like Lady is sitting back there like screaming at like the TV because she knows what I'm doing and she just doesn't want to give into it yet. Some of them make sense, right? Like, obviously, we play a lot of Among Us, but how could I do an Among Us section, right? Like, I can't get everyone on to be like, hey, guys, we're going to play, like, one game of Among Us. Show up for one game. Some games don't make a ton of sense for me to revisit either, so we'll figure it out. We'll figure out what's the best approach. That's gonna be at the end of March. All right, and now I need two of these. Okay, we've got two, and then I need one of you plugs. It doesn't really matter which direction I put the plug, because it's the first one, but once I've put it, then I'll be able to, like, this always has to be the same direction. Yeah, precisely. That's like, kind of the thought process we've got. But it's also, like I went through and I looked at all the categories I've ever streamed in. There's 132 of them. Right. So doesn't make sense to try to cram 5 minutes in for all those type of things. So we're working it out because, again, it's like I don't want to do like 10 minutes per game. So we're, you know, we're figuring out what's the right combination, what's the right amount of stuff. But yeah, we definitely are going to do our best. Exactly. The genres is, I think, where we're at with it, just so that we don't get too big. And then the question is, do we play an old game that we played on stream in that genre, or do we play a new game that we've never played on stream in that genre? You know, we'll figure it out. Aloha, Ami. How are you doing, my good friend? Welcome to the stream. It's always a pleasure to have you here. All right. This is what I was talking about. This has to be this direction. This one has to be 90 degrees from that. They're very clear. That has to be turned. A busy weekend. That's excellent. Excellent. I like a good busy weekend. I know not everyone does, but I feel like there's a level of busyness that I'm okay with. One. Two. And three. And so hopefully you aren't beyond that level of busy. Okay, now this one has to be 180 degrees from that one. Excuse me. And then we can put that little slider attachment on. Oh God, we're building something funky. We're building something really funky here. All right, so we've built this monstrosity, and we're just gonna put this off to the side because we have to build a second one. And I'm just gonna build it here on the actual, like, table at this point. All right, and now we're gonna do two of these. One. This is gonna be so much easier to have it built on a plate like that, like you can just pick the pieces up. All right, this one we're gonna have facing towards me. And then we're going to do with another one of yous. This is great because this is what, like, the little ledges grip onto. Aw. Wait, what? Series 25? No, no. Stop, Siri. Stop, Siri. I have a box of Series 25s. This is the new Lego number one prize. You get to pick which one box I open. I've got like series 25 and 2 of the Marvel. So I think it's series 24. And then I will build that on stream and put it on the mat behind me. And every time like a new series of minifigures will come out, I'll buy another 6-pack and we'll just add it to the queue. That's what we're gonna do with those. That's pretty dope. That's exciting. I'm really excited about the next series. Like the next series may be one that I try to get like them all. I know that they've changed it, so it's gonna be nearly impossible for someone to get 12 out of 12 right off the bat. Like, I remember doing that with The Simpsons. You could, like, feel the bags. So I may just, like, have to buy a bunch. 1, 2, 3. Beechcraft 801, contact Pollock 20, approach on 119er decimal 75. 4. Good day. 5. Okay, what else? Beechcraft 801. Oh, there you go. Okay. Okay. Food chopping is good. Macaroni salad is delicious. Good choices all around. I support that. You got the full set except for the film noir guy. I got this guy already off the bat. My good friend, or one of the people who I absolutely love on stream, her name is Jean's Vision. She was building and she gave this away on stream. that I got that. Coleslaw is the only acceptable salad. Well, one is Homer Simpson said you don't make friends with salad. But I support anyone having macaroni salad or potato salad or any one of the salads out there. They're all delicious salads. All right, and now we take these two things which we've built, and they connect like this. So I can put that over there. School food lunch can be very expensive. 1,000%. I get that. Especially colleges. Ooh. They think people just print money there. Okay, so we're going to start with this 2x6. And we're going to take you. And you. And then we're going to take these connector pins. That does sound pretty delicious, not going to lie. Because it's funny, so as I've been thinking about like the 500 screen, I've thrown like so many ideas out there, like maybe we could do this, maybe we could do this, maybe we could do this. And like I really do like the Eras Tour concept. I think it's the one that makes the most sense. Alright, and then this little bad boy goes right on like that. And then that connects into you like that. And then we have to build the two more that go on the other side of this because we're building a group of four. That's what we're doing. Woo! This is a 16er. Luckily, we have two of them, so I'm just going to put the other one over there because I know I'm going to need that in a hot second. I'm not a big fan of coleslaw any which way. I'm not a big salad person. I didn't used to be a soup person, but I'm starting to get into soups. I don't know if I'm ever going to be one of those people who's like, you know what's the best thing on a cold day? A soup. I like hot cocoa on a cold day. But ooh! I thought of something, and I felt hella smart for thinking of this. And so I want your praise and adoration for thinking of this, because I feel like I deserve a medal for it. So I like hot cocoa, but I really shouldn't be having hot cocoa because of the sugar. Not that I'm diabetic or even pre-diabetic. I should follow what's known as a FODMAP diet, which is basically it's like I'm like lactose intolerant, but with sugar. It's the best way to put it. So I can have it. I'm just going to suffer through it, right? Like I had a Dr. Pepper the other day because I was driving home from McDonald's, and because I wanted a large fries, they gave me a large Dr. Pepper, and like I suffered for the Dr. Pepper, which is fine. I am okay with that. Okay. So one has got to be there. Okay, so that means this has to go this way. And so my brilliant idea, which again, feel free to start praising me before I even tell you what this great idea is. What if I took my chocolate protein powder and I tried to make hot cocoa with it? Right. Like, that's a pretty genius idea, if you ask me. Johannesburg Center. Needless to say, it wasn't. Oh, Ami, you are the best. So yeah, I did that, and yeah, it wasn't. It was like it clearly had potential. It clearly is a thing that like I will do again, as opposed to next time I want hot cocoa. I'm instead of being like, oh, let's actually get some hot, get some Swiss Miss out. Let's just, you know, let's do this instead. This works. It's like 85% of the way there. And I think that's the most important thing about anyone when they're doing any type of health journey, because, and they're trying to overcome their bad food habits, because it's so hard to be like, I'm going to eat nothing but tofu for the rest of my life and like it. You have to be able to say to yourself, this is what I'm going to do instead, right? So like one of the things I really like is I like having pizza, and I like having a lot of pizza. So as opposed to like, so like every other week I get this $3 pizza from Aldi that is small. It's big enough that I feel like I ate a lot of pizza, but it's not so big that like it will destroy me. And I get to do that, and that helps me feel like I had a pizza, and I got to gorge on the pizza. 3, 4, 5. Okay. And then we got this, and so that's also gonna go like that. And then we're gonna put 3 more on. 1, 2, and 3. There we go. And then you two can connect together like that. And then that, of course, has those two plugs out that way. And then those two plugs plug into you like that. And that's how we get that throne-looking thing. Now, this throne-looking thing... is gonna go right here. Okay. This needs to get clicked in right there, because then when they connect together, that gets laid down on that. Okay. And now we're going to start building some of these support beams that we get to put in here. So yeah, that's what I did. I'm pretty proud of myself for that. Okay. How many dots is that? How many is that? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That gets offset by 2. And we can put you there. And then we can take the 4x1 underneath. And then that's going to go on top like that. And then 1, 2, 3, and we have that. And that is going to be the secondary support beam between those two pillars there. So you can see, wrong direction. I just built this support pillar here. How are we doing on our flight, by the way? 178 nautical miles. And we're gonna build another one, and this is gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. There we go. And now that is going to get clicked into there. These are just things that Lego has done to add some stability to the structure. All right, and these ones are going to be much shorter. So this is a 6. And I have to build 3 of these. As you can see, all we're doing is click, 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 and then you 4 go on. And it's going to go 1. And we got one more of those to build. And then you're gonna go there, and then you guys get clicked in. Like that. Okay, that's coming together very nicely. It's hard to show the angles on these, I'm not gonna lie. It's hard to show the angles. This is the only there's 2 that are kind of the same length. 3. So I'm going to assume this is the one. I don't know exactly if it is the one, but we'll find out. Okay, so. Holiest Toledos, ladies and gentlemen, I want to give a big mahalo to our first time chatter who just popped into the chat. Her name is Becca. She is a lovely, sweet, wonderful human being. Feel free to go check her out. I cannot speak highly enough of her. She is super sweet, super nice on stream, and just a wonderful person. Please, everyone, go check her out. I do not think I have any mods who are actively chatting right now, so I'm going to give her a shout-out myself. But she does, like, crochet streams. She does all types of fun stuff. Boom. So right now what we're doing is we have 2 things going on in our stream. So on our Sunday night streams, we're on a round the world journey and we build Lego once we reach cruising altitude. So right now we're between Johannesburg, South Africa and Hippo Valley, Zimbabwe. And at the same time, we are working on the Lego Loop roller coaster set, which looks like this. So we're on bag number 3 right now. So we've built the base, and this is what we're building right now. But that's what we're doing. We're cruising altitude about 10,000 feet. We got 163 nautical miles to go. It is going to be fun. It's going to be so awesome to have this one built. Toa just came over and said, "What am I building? Don't tell me, I want to guess." And then I'm like, "This is exactly what we're building. Don't bother guessing." I'm so sorry I did that to you. I'm so sorry I ruined the fun of your day. It was not my intent to do that. Timing was pretty amazing. I do have to give myself credit for that. So right now we're building a support beam. And Becca, you were streaming earlier today, right? How was it? Because you were playing Super Mario Sunshine. How was that today? Apologize, didn't make it. It is the first Sunday of the month, and that is always the most stressful for me with church commitment, so I was unable to pop in. You beat it tonight. Congratulations. That's awesome. It's always the most stressful one for me. I barely got to stream here myself on time, just between commitments and stuff. So, yeah. Everyone does the best that they can. This is always the Sunday where I get to watch absolutely no one on stream. Is that really going to go on like that? Okay, that's interesting. They're going to use a little split things. That's awesome. What's the next game you're going to play after this? So we built that. We're going to use this piece, which is, of course, a wrench or sometimes a claw arm. Ooh. I haven't been up that early, but... let's see. I got to church at 9 to start the stream. And then between that, I was there till about 12:30. And then I came home and I had a couple hours to do some meal prep at home. And then from that, I had to go back to church because it's chapel kids at night tonight. So I could drop my kids off for that. And then I got to sit around and read a book. So it wasn't like I was really doing much, but it's just like the amount of time it would take me to do that than come home. It's just easier to stay there. And so that's what we did. And it was totally fine and worth it. This is exciting. This is going to go way over here. Like that. It's hard to see. And then I got home at like 6:37. I'm like, all right, I got 23 minutes to get on stream. I mean, luckily I did a bunch of stuff yesterday and in the morning today to make sure that I could handle that. So this is what we just built on. We added on here. And I'm so glad I have this buffer space here. Like, I couldn't have planned that any better. This is perfect. This is perfect. I have like a one stud variant over here. You still need to finish the first one. I've never played either of them. I've only heard good things about those games. I am a Xbox person, so I don't have them. Oh, Stardon, I'm so sorry you have to get up so early. Oof. Ami needs to get up early tomorrow. I get up at like 5:30 in the weekdays, unfortunately. There's nothing wrong with being an evening person or a morning person. You got to do what's best for you as an individual. Looks like I'm going to build this a couple times.
Sorry I'm late. Forgive me for bringing the kids. I couldn't get a sitter.
Please have a seat. As I was saying, in a world of predominantly male-oriented psychology, it was only natural to arrive at the term P. P. Pete be envy.
You said suck. My kids could be watching. Whereas Audrey says, Daddy, I know all the swears. I had to define what are swears, and it, you know, suck just ended up being one of them. Because the rule of thumb, I have the highest moderation settings in terms of Twitch allowing words and not allowing words. So every time a word would get caught by that, that just became one of the swears. For better or worse, that's just what we did. Becca loved the first game you finally get. Ooh, that's awesome. That is awesome. That is awesome. Always good to have friends who are able to give you PS5s. Not that there's anything wrong with friends who cannot give you a PS5. Just more stating that if you have one who can, it's a good friend to have. All right, and then that's going to go in there. That's going to go there, and then I get that up there. Now this is going to go right in like that. I get it. I get it. So here's my thought process. If the friend has enough money to give their friend something like that, like, you know, it's very generous. It's very nice. But yeah, no, if you have a friend who's got enough money to do something like that, go for it. Right? All right. I mean, we don't have that kind of money, but I don't know, we live a comfortable existence. You know, it's a good way to do it. That's a good way to do it. It's a good way to do it. Then they're very generous person, and they're very blessed to be doing something like that, and that is awesome. Oh, I have to build this twice? What? Did they warn me I was doing this twice? They did warn me I was doing this twice. Darn it. You never know. You never know, as a teacher, you may get that opportunity to do something like that. It's funny, the economics of being a teacher, right? And I don't mean funny as in ha-ha, but funny as in what I always thought to be true isn't necessarily true anymore. So I'm going to tell a story. So gather around, children. This is story time with me. As many of you know, I grew up in an inner city. Again, no shame with that. I thoroughly enjoy being from the inner city. So I'm from Oakland, California, and Oakland has a very rich suburb in the middle of it called Piedmont, California. And the best way to think about it is, if you're in Oakland and you're rich, you're in Piedmont. Like, that's just the best way to think about it. It's a town that's completely surrounded by Oakland. When Oakland was being formed, there were a bunch of little towns, and Piedmont just didn't get the paperwork filed properly to join Oakland. And so thus they've kind of enjoyed being a rich little town in the middle of Oakland, have all the benefits of being in Oakland without any of the problems of being in Oakland. And my math teacher, my eighth grade year, got jumped after school. And it was kind of one of those really scary things for everyone who was there to watch it happen. And the next year, he left Oakland to go teach in Piedmont. And I knew him, not necessarily outside of school, but I knew him, you know, like we had enough overlap in our social circles that him going to Piedmont wasn't the end of me being aware of his existence. And at the time, I always thought he left to go to Piedmont because, of course, Piedmont would pay their teachers better. Like, that just was the only thing that made any sense to me. And he was like, no. Piedmont paid garbage compared to Oakland. Because you taught in Piedmont, so you didn't have to deal with kids from Oakland. And him getting jumped after school by some kids was kind of like it for him. So he took a pay cut, left to go to Piedmont. And, so I just always assumed that, yes, exactly what you said, the harder the school, the better the paycheck. So then I'm sitting here in Massachusetts now, and Newton is a rich suburb of Boston, and their teachers are going on strike right now. It's illegal for them to go on strike, but they are doing the right thing for them and going on strike, and hopefully they're able to get what they're looking for. But one of the things that was I found so fascinating as they've been going through this journey is finding out how Newton Newton actually pays better than non-Newton schools. And because, you know, there is, of course, backlash from people like, oh, God, if Newton teachers think they are worth this much, then what about the teachers in Boston? Right. Like, you know, that type of thing. And it's just fascinating to me to kind of like listen to and watch. One of my common held beliefs that, you know, the harder the school, the better the pay. And at least clearly in the difference between Newton and Boston, that is not the case. Teachers in Newton have a better salary than those in Boston. There we go. Oh, you guys saw none of that. I'm so sorry. Well, that was the end of the bag. So I can just do it this way. We built this. The cool thing about this is it's kind of a slope. So I don't know which way the things are going to go, but this goes up and then this goes down and around. I don't know which part of this is going to attach over to the main part and which part attaches to the loop. But this is kind of where this is. But this is a great opportunity to do a prize wheel spin for Ami. If you have 100 Mahalo rewards points, feel free to redeem a prize wheel. May the odds forever be in your favor. Eight.
Congratulations. Daddy has to build Lego or do whatever he's doing, you think? Please.
Okay. How are we doing on bags? Time will allow it. We're 111 miles out, so we'll do the next. So this is bag number 4, and I need 2 bags. I forgot I already did bag 4. We're going to bag 5! And I need 2 bags. We'll open it up and then we'll get started with the oven mitts. If you missed it earlier, we had to build with chopsticks. That went very well. I impressed everyone with my abilities to use chopsticks. I attribute it to the fact that I was a foreign exchange student in Japan as a sophomore in high school. And that's why I'm really good at chopsticks. Like, I went there and I was like, you know, my host family, I don't think they were expecting to get someone who knew very little about Japanese culture. And they're like, we can give you a fork. I'm like, nah. If I come back from Japan after being a student here and I do not know how to use chopsticks, I am going to get ribbed so hard by everyone I know. Like, I will never hear the end of that. All right. Okay, bag 4 we've already built. Oh, wait. Yep. Okay. Still building that up. Okay, and that's where they connect. And that's where that gets done. All right. Let's get 5 minutes on the clock. And of course, I know I'm only supposed to do it for 5 minutes. But I most likely will, like, finish, like, the thing I'm working on because I'm stubborn. All right. Right off the bat. I need a 4x1. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to start with you. And then I need... So the thing I found is this works better if I can build it kind of on a plate. So we're going to build right there. Nope. Come on. Let's get that on. Right, and that way I can just pull it off later when I'm done. All right. Okay, I'm gonna need... let's see. I might as well get all the pieces that I need out. Nope. Two. I need one more. All right, let's see if I can get that. That one's gonna be easier to get. Nope. Yep, okay, and I can get this back. Should I really be able to use extra tools? Yes. I'm not using anything that I don't have in front of me. I need one of those. I need a one. There. Nope.
Center Beechcraft 6801 7200 feet. Beechcraft
6801 Hillary Center altimeter 290 decimal minor. Two radar contact. Continue. Alright. I'm not gonna use my hand. I'm not gonna use my mouth. I'm gonna just use my hands. There he goes. I didn't get it. Darn it. Okay. I know. Let's do that. Okay, I'm gonna do another thing. I am going to get there it goes, that piece I need. Alright, and now I need a 4x1 tile. Voila. Alright. Now we're gonna start by getting this piece on. Okay. Like that. And then that goes on like that. And then that can go on like that. And then this needs to go underneath. And then that's going to go on like that. So much struggle for such an easy step. I know. And then... that's going to go on like... that. Ta-da! And now where does this go? Stop the timer. Where does this go? This goes right there. Okay, so that's going to get in like that, and then that folds down like that. And that's one of the things they do to secure the two sides, which we don't have to worry about because we built this on Mills plates. So the piece that we just put in went right here. ...68 nautical miles. We got more time. Ooh, look at this piece that we're going to be building. Okay. So... right, this is the piece. This is the piece. How many pieces do I need? How many studs? I wish Lego would put in the thing how many studs something has. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. And we're gonna take a 3 and a 2 to go on top of that. 2x1 to connect these two like that, and then we're gonna need this ball joint piece, a 2x1, then a 3x1. It's moments like these that I wish I had a much bigger desk. This is like precariously perched right now. All right, and then we're going to put that there. That is too big. I need a 4x1. There we go. There's a 4x1. And that's a 6. It's not a plate. There's my tile. Like that. And then I have to put the other side of the ball joint. You. So we built a ball joint. And then the ball joints can get put over into that. That's interesting. That's interesting. I want to make sure you guys can see that when we make that step. Wrong direction as always. So this is going to go over here. And it clicks into that. But this ball joint clicks onto this little thing here. So that is nice and good. How are we on our flight? We got one more thing we can build. Maybe 2 if it goes quick. If it goes quick is the key phrase. 2. And then that's going to go on a 4. And then a 10. And then that's 6. And then that gives me a 4. And then I can get this 2 to click on there. And I have these 6 ones, which click in just like that. And then that is going to go here under this gap. Here. All right. And now we got some shorter ones. I have to build this 3 times. So that's going to be easy because these are going to be 6 longs. So we go with a 6. Then our little grip. A 2. Another little grip. And then a 4. And they're going to go onto this spot, and over here. There it is. So again, a grip 2, a second grip 2, a 2x1, and then a 4x1, and you can fit just in there like that. And then we have to build that one more time. The grip 2, the 2x1, the grip 2, the 4x1. And then that is going to go all the way over to this last one over here, which is off camera, which you can't see. But it just continues over. Right there. This is such a big set. And we're under 50 miles, so we're going to go back and fly.
Now I want you to disengage the automatic pilot. Watch out you don't make any violent control movements like you did in the fighter plane.
All right, I'm going to unlock the automatic pilot.
Just remember, the controls will feel very heavy compared to a fighter. Don't worry about that, it's perfectly normal.
I always love that one. Stream manager, there it goes. I want to be able to see the chat closer to me right now. Your dad is building the Cab Bane ship for Bad Batch. I still haven't watched Bad Batch. I hear it's funny. I just haven't watched it. There we go. There we go. I'm going to actually put the keyboard over here. The keyboard was blocking just enough of the screen. Okay. There we go. And now we're flying. We're at 4,200 feet. Well, we don't have Disney Plus anymore. So that's our excuse. We got rid of it. We dumped it. Which I know for a lot of people, like, you have kids. How do you dump it? Easy. We dumped it. Because I keep hearing about, like, people when they're talking about, like, how, like, streaming is becoming the new cable with all the bundling and all the packages, and you have to have all the... You don't. You can be perfectly fine with just one subscription. You're not going to be able to watch everything, and I think that's one of the things people don't understand, is we're in an era of peak television. We've been in this era for a long time, since, like, 2005 or so, where there's so much good content out there. That unless you have absolutely no life, you will not be able to see all the content out there. It's just not going to exist. But I think people have this belief that they can, and they try to have it all, and they try to make it all happen. And then you get, like, the people who try to shame them for having not seen this show or that show. And I'm just, you know, not about that. We're at 33 nautical miles. I've never seen Gilmore Girls or Sopranos. Haven't seen either of them. And I know a lot of people say Sopranos is a show you have to watch. I struggle with organized crime content. I just do. I struggle with it. It's not something that I like. I've seen Goodfellas. I've seen The Godfather. I just struggle with that type of content because I think to some degree there is, although these characters are meant to be cautionary tales and they're meant to be anti-heroes, I do believe there is a lot of the people who watch the shows who idolize characters like that as opposed to recognizing them for what they are. And that, I think that's one of the reasons why I struggle with those type of shows is because I just... Gilmore Girls, again, I've heard... I think of the two, I'd be more inclined to watch Gilmore Girls of the two. Of the two, I would probably watch that one more. Because I did really like... what's her name in Parenthood? I thought she was phenomenal at Laura Graham in Parenthood. I thought she did such a good job in that show. Yeah, and there's a lot of good quality actors and actresses that I've seen who were, got their break on Gilmore Girls to some degree. Which is why I think I would enjoy it more. You know, the few times I've seen James Gandolfini outside of Sopranos, I've never been impressed with him. Every single time I've been like, okay, go on. I mean, maybe he just picks bad roles. But I remember there was this one movie with Robert Redford where Gandolfini was like the head of like a military prison, and he just played the biggest douche. And it was almost like, dude, you are like top of the world with Tony Soprano, and this is the role you got? This is the one you're excited about? Getting shown up by Robert Redford in a movie?
122.6 Beechcraft 801. Goodbye.
All right. It looks like we're getting very close. I need to get lower, by the way. We're at 20 nautical miles and about 5,000 feet. Again, we're going to fly over our target. To see which way the runway is. Yeah, and like, what's her name? Alexis Bledel. I think she's done such a great job in Handmaid's Tale. Laura Graham, phenomenal in Parenthood. What's her name is always really funny. I don't know why I can't think of her name right now. Melissa McCarthy, always really funny. She gets typecast at sometimes, but again, she's really good at what she does. You know, I think it's an important thing for actors and people in general to recognize what makes them great and then exploit it for their game. Look at this scenery. This is absolutely beautiful world. We're looking at right below us. We're at 4,600 feet. We've got a good little decline right now. We're going to have a good landing. I'm very excited about this landing. We're trying something new. Again, like I said, we're going to fly over. We're going to see which direction the... Yeah. Alexis Bledel was in Handmaid's. She played the... she played one of the handmaids. She was the one who had her sensitive lady part cut off. And she was the one who fled into Canada with June's baby. That's who she was in that. And again, phenomenal in that role. showed so much vulnerability in her role. And you really could see her acting chops later in it when she first gets into Canada and she reunites with her wife. Just really shows her ability to act and showcase. All right, we're 10 nautical miles. I still think we're a little high, but I'm okay with our distance above the ground because we are going to do the loop over. Hopefully the clouds that we're flying through aren't going to stop us from being able to see which way is the runway. As we fly through the clouds right now. Yeah, but this is something they've really been teaching me in, like, the little flight training. Not that I'm doing official flight training, but the game's flight training is fly over stuff. Oh, mahalo for being here, Becca. It's always a pleasure to have you. You're always welcome here. You know, we try to have a inclusive, friendly environment for all of our friends to feel welcome and enjoy themselves. So I'm glad that you're able to be here. Enjoy your dinner. Hopefully it is delicious and you enjoy consuming it. As we are coming to our landing, we're at 3,700 feet. I'm going to slow the engines down a little bit. We're 5 nautical miles out, and I still feel like we're a little high. But again, we do have to swoop around. Like, if I was trying to land in 4 miles, we'd be a much lower. But I don't think we need to. I really do want to reduce my airspeed because that is going to make the landing that much easier. Okay, here we go. Let's see this airport, y'all. Which way is our runway? We're 2 nautical miles out. There does not appear to be much of a runway, y'all. This may be an airstrip. Like, just like a little... Who are we going to raid tonight? I don't know. You got any suggestions for me? I mean, there that appears to be a little town there. All right, here we're passing over. It is definitely a dirt runway. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to swoop around to the left. Maybe there's some asphalt. We'll find out.
Foxtrot Victor Hotel Yankee, traffic Beechcraft, 68011 miles southwest, 3,500.
Now we've passed over. But yeah, if you know someone who's online right now that you feel like I should raid, I've completely passed. And I want to zoom out so I can see my runway a little better. Ooh, nope, we are. This is a good little rotation we got going on. We got good speed, good altitude. All right, we're almost halfway done with our turn. Oh, there's our little Tron gates. Look at that, y'all. We're getting Tron gates. I love the Tron gates. This, you don't see this in real life, but you do get to see this in game. Aloha, Sam. How are you doing, my friend? Son. What? You want to show everyone your trumpet? Oh, we're climbing too much. I was talking to Sam. He wants to play the trumpet for y'all. What, Sam?
Well done, Sam. It is properly tuned. The trumpet. Yeah. But Sam, it's not just that you hold the right keys down when you're playing a trumpet. You have to blow at the in the mouthpiece at different angles. I will show you as soon as the stream is over. Ooh. As you can see, we're in the middle of the landing pattern right now, and we're getting an impromptu concert. She will not say it's not properly tuned, but she'll say, "Why are you not playing your saxophone?" That is the instrument that you're playing. All right, here we go. Oh, we're too fast. I'll show you too fast. You never got to play an instrument as a kid? Why didn't you get to play an instrument as a kid? Try to slow down some more. I honestly don't know how to get any slower. Man, they're having us do the full loop around. It's a beautiful little lake down there, though. See, I'm not worried about going too fast. I'm worried about height and distance. And lining things up. All right, how about if we pull it down a little more? Oh, it like that. So I was just barely too fast. I was like 1 mile too fast and like this too fast, guys. Too fast again. All right, I'm not worrying about it. Oh, no. We're about to hit an ad break in 2 minutes. Just as we're at the exciting part of the stream where I have to try to land. Okay. All right, there we go. All right, we got blue Tron bars. We're doing great. I am proud of this. We got 2 minutes till an ad break, and we have 4.4 nautical miles. We're gonna try to land before the ad break. That is the dream, that is the goal. Yeah, so that was actually my cornet growing up. I forget why my dad bought me a cornet, but my dad bought me a cornet at one point. I mean, I was playing the trumpet, or maybe I was playing the cornet. Whatever it is. Now my kids play with it when they're just bored, I guess. All right, we're going to lower our landing gear. We're going to come into our landing. All right, I snooze the ad for 5 minutes. I want to make sure you guys catch the landing. Yeah, I'm too low, so I don't care that I'm going too fast. There it goes. Oh. Come on, and I gotta make it there. I gotta make it there, guys. There, I changed my flaps. That's gonna get me, I think, that last mile. All right, I'm stalling. Come on, guys, we can make this. We're not making it. Thank you for flying Tiki Bricks Airways. We hope you enjoyed our flight, our regularly scheduled flight to Hippo Valley. We didn't make it this time, but maybe we'll make it next time. Feel free to walk the remaining block or so to the airport. I knew I shouldn't have followed the little Tron things. They led me astray. Led me astray, I swear it. All right, it's 9:10, y'all. We are going to continue this. It was a happy little ending. Exactly. We will finish this next week. Because I do need to get to bed and all that wonderful stuff. So let's find someone to write. If you know someone who's online right now that you feel like, hey, cross meet this person, this is a great opportunity to drop their name in the chat while I go find the people who I'm following. We're going to snooze that. Because we want to do our outro song. You group therapy tomorrow. That's exciting. That was a maybe. I wouldn't really like to rate them, but they're playing with another person. And I always struggle with that. Yes. Isn't Aran the Quest your mod, Clover? I thought I saw them online. Let's do that. Let's raid a new friend. I've never been in his stream before, but he's a good dude, at least from what I can tell from Clover O's stream. Already swearing on us, so it's doing great. All right, so we're going to go into there. We're going to go into this. We're going to snooze so that we can get through our things. Ooh, I started that way too early. Let's get to our raid stream. Ain't never thought it'd be so tough to close the stream. Flying high, yeah, in Microsoft skies. plane was soaring through clouds so high. But now that we've landed, good aloha. 'Cause I can never make. No, I couldn't do that, chat. Only wish I didn't have to go. Makes it so, so very hard to go. Cause it's time to race. I've got to go to bed. We're not making through the whole song ever, and I apologize. Here we go. Lego bricks clicking as the plane cruises on. In this virtual cockpit, yeah, as it says taking shape. Alright, I'm just gonna end it because it's just you guys on YouTube. Mahalo for being here, every one of you. I greatly appreciate you. See you guys next Friday.